Okay, so don't ask me how, but I recently went down the rabbit hole of looking into Pokemon math formulas. Damage can be for another day, but today I'm going to share how EVs and IVs have worked throughout Pokemon, because not only do they work differently in the first two gens, but I can even teach you the Pokemon stat formula to show you what stats a base stat total will give, to help you balance any fake mon you make, and that goes for me too. How else do you think I fell into this rabbit hole? But to understand how odd EVs and IVs worked in gens 1 and 2, we need to know how they work now. So what are EVs and IVs? EV stands for effort value, and IV stands for individual value. EVs are a stat that can increase and customize by defeating certain Pokemon, and IVs are a randomly generated stat. In a normal playthrough, they honestly don't matter all that much, but in competitive, they are everything. A Pokemon can have an overall maximum of 510 EVs, and each stat can have a maximum of 252 EVs. When a Pokemon reaches level 100, their stat will have an extra point for every 4 EVs they have. So in practice, a stat with max EVs will have 63 extra points. The difference is less obvious in lower levels, but still there. As an example, let's say we have two level 50 Mimikyus, each with the same attack. However, if we feed Mimikyu A a bunch of proteins and max out its attack EVs, then its attack will increase by 32 points. There are various ways to get EVs. Vitamins are the most efficient, giving you 10 EVs per vitamin, but the classic way is by defeating Pokemon. Each Pokemon gives out certain EVs when defeated. Caterpie gives 1 HP EV, Leafeon gives 2 defense EVs, etc. And if your Pokemon holds a power item or is infected with the elusive Pokerus, then the EV yield opponents give will be doubled. And now, IVs. A Pokemon can have up to 31 IVs. And similarly to EVs, when a Pokemon reaches level 100, it will have 31 extra stat points. Using our Mimikyu example again, at level 50, a Mimikyu will have a special defense stat of 125 if it has 31 IVs, or 110 if it has 0 IVs. However, unlike EVs, you don't have entire control over IVs. Under normal circumstances, wild Pokemon have random IVs, aside from legendaries and overworld encounters, who are guaranteed to have some perfect IVs. And many games nowadays have ways to guarantee perfect IVs. Sun and Moon and BDSP have chains, Let's Go has catch combos, and Sword and Shield has raid dens. And with the Destiny Knot, Pokemon with perfect IVs can pass on those IVs to their offspring. But don't worry if you don't want to grind for perfect IVs, because Sun and Moon introduced hyper training. If you have bottle caps, you can give it to a man who hyper trained a level 100 Pokemon. This will give him the stats of a Pokemon with perfect IVs. The only difference is that when you breed them, the game will only consider their original IVs. So now that we have all that covered, forget all of it. At least for the Game Boy era games, because the EV and IV system is completely different in those games. In fact, IVs don't exist in them. Instead, they have DVs, determinant values. At level 100, a Pokemon with 15 DVs will have 30 extra stat points. So pretty similar to IVs actually. However, DVs also determine other factors of a Pokemon. DVs also determine a Pokemon's gender and whether they're shiny or not. But that's a whole other can of worms. But anyways, EVs were a whole different thing. You know how nowadays each Pokemon gives certain EVs? Well, in the GB era, Pokemon gave EVs based on their base stats. For all stats. For example, Fur gave 85 HP EVs, 75 attack EVs, 64 defense EVs, 45 special attack EVs, 55 special defense EVs, and 90 speed EVs, all at once. Which sounds like you would max out your EVs pretty quickly, right?
Nope.
Because each stat could have a maximum of 65,535 EVs, and you could max out each stat all at once. So unlike the balance of today where only two stats can have max EVs, in the GB era you can max out every stat. At level 100, every stat will get a boost of 63 with maxed EVs. So make sure to fight lots of Pokemon or use vitamins, which in these generations give 2,560 EVs, but cannot be used on a stat that has at least 25,600 EVs. Okay, so max DVs will boost stats by 30 and max EVs will boost stats by 63, which is more similar to modern mechanics than I let on. But now for the thing I'm most excited to talk about, the stat formulas. Here is the modern formula, HP having a different formula from the other stats. You start by multiplying the base stat by 2, then you add it to the IV and the EV, after the EV has been divided by 4, and whatever you get should be multiplied by the Pokemon's level, and whatever you get after should be divided by 100. And here's where the difference between HP and the other stats comes into play. For HP, you will add the sum to the Pokemon's level with an additional 10, and for the other stats, you will add 5 to the sum, and then account for the Pokemon's nature. You multiply by 1.1 if it's a stat boosting nature, or by 0.9 if it's a stat lowering nature. But the formula used for Gens 1 and 2 is very much different. To account for the different EV and IV system, the GB formula is adding the base stat to the Pokemon's DV, then multiply the sum by 2, add it to the square root of the Pokemon's EVs, which is divided by 4, multiply all of that by the Pokemon's level, and then divide the sum by 100. If you're calculating HP, you add everything to the level plus 10, and for the other stats, you add 5. Boy, that was a lot to talk about. But there is still something I'd like to bring up, and it's that using these formulas, you never round up. It's weird, but important if you want to make a fake mon with accurate stats. I first found this out with Mew. I was fiddling with the Mon stat formula, and comparing it to what Wikipedia says Mew's stats should be. My calculation told me that a Mew with perfect IVs, full EV investment, and a positive nature should have 328.9 as its stat. When I first saw that, I thought, oh, well, I guess it would be 329 after you round up. But according to Wikipedia, its non-HP stats would be 328, meaning the 0.9 is completely ignored. I thought that maybe I made a miscalculation, but after doing it multiple times, I kept getting 328.9, and so I decided to use some of my own Pokemon. I used my IV bred Mimikyu and Bayonet as test subjects. Both have best in all IVs except special attack, full attack and speed EVs, and MQ has an impish nature while Sheriff has a jolly nature. And the numbers matched up. MQ's defense is 110, and the calculation add up to 110.55. Sheriff's speed is 128, and the calculation add up to 128.7. So I guess the lesson here is if you ever want to make a fake mon and have a stat chart like Wikipedia's, then just completely ignore any decimals. And there you have it, folks. A complete explanation of what EVs and IVs are, how they're different in the Game Boy era games, and how the stats of your Pokemon are calculated. If you'd like to see more videos like this, let me know. I like obscure facts. Have a nice day, you wonderful people.